All right, hello everyone. Welcome to this episode of the Connect series. Thank you for joining us. If this is your first time here, this is a series where we go over some of the great and exciting connectivity technologies coming out. We also have a podcast, so make sure to check that out. I'm really excited today. We have a special guest, Nicholas from Radiocrafts. He's the sales and marketing coordinator there. He's going to talk about some new technology in the low power wireless space and also some of the things he's doing. Thanks for joining us, Nicholas.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I'm very excited to talk to you guys today about MIOTY.
Awesome. Yeah, so first and foremost, tell us a little bit about Radiocrafts, who you are, what you do, and then we'll jump into some technology-specific discussion.
Yeah, so Radiocrafts is a radio frequency module and network solution provider. We have sold over 3 million modules globally around the world, and we provide standard modules such as wireless M-Bus, Zigbee, Sigfox, and then we have our own solutions as well, like our IP mesh solution, industrial IoT solutions as well. And then we also offer like customizable modules as well. So we do a wide variety of radio module customization and standard modules for the global market.
Okay, yeah, great. Yeah, makes sense. And you mentioned this in the intro a little bit, but we're here to talk about MIOTY and how TI and Radiocrafts are partnering on this exciting new technology. Now, first of all, I'm really curious if you can tell me what MIOTY is, but second of all, can you spell it? Because I hear it pronounced and said a bunch of ways, but yeah, give me a little intro into MIOTY.
So the MIOTY solution was released in February of 2020 this year, and Radiocrafts releases this solution as a true stepping stone into true IoT scalability and mass deployment as well. And what MIOTY is that it was designed for the best-in-class reliability, scalability, and battery lifetime out of all existing LPWANs today. And this is quite a bold statement, but it is possible because of a technology within MIOTY called telegram splitting, which basically what this does is that you take a MIOTY data packet, you split it into several sub-packets, and then you send these sub-packets in various different frequencies and times, and then the MIOTY base station will scan the spectrum for these MIOTY sub-packets and will collect these sub-packets and receive these sub-packets and will create the complete message again. But what is truly amazing about MIOTY is the redundancy, which is possible with the forward error correction feature in MIOTY, which allows you to lose up to 50% of your sub-packets, and in the end, you can still form a complete message without losing any content information. So this really shows the robustness of MIOTY in the sense that even with interference present, there is a level of redundancy and very strong interference blocking, which allows the MIOTY to be very resilient against noise and interferences.
Okay. Wow. Yeah. That's very exciting. So, it sounds like it's a new LPWAN standard. It runs on the sub gig band, and you know, you mentioned a couple things: robustness, resiliency against noise, some features that'll make it very exciting. Can you talk about maybe some of the applications that you foresee this technology will be used for?
Yeah, so the way Radiocrafts sees this is that the MIOTY will be used for mainly uplink-dominated use cases. We see that it'll have an impact on projects with a very long project lifetime. And this is mainly due to the license-free bands, because as we see in the license-free bands, they're becoming quite crowded now with all the devices in these license-free bands and all the different technologies as well, which are coexisting in the license-free spectrum and are creating a lot of interference between each other, but also just the noise and interference from the surrounding environment as well. So then this can create a lot of interference and therefore a lot of data loss and packet loss, which MIOTY does not see this kind of packet loss and interference because of this telegram splitting technology, which allows it to be very resilient towards these external interferers. So we see that MIOTY is a very good use case for these long lifetime projects, as well as battery operated devices as well, because these sub packets, they have very short airtime of around 15 milliseconds. So then there's very little chance of data collision, and so we see that it is a very robust and battery-friendly solution because of this short airtime as well. And then we see it functioning very well in high node count volumes as well, high node count applications such as, for example, smart metering, where you have a very dense amount of devices inside, for example, each household, which in an urban environment can be quite dense. So we see that you can have up to like tens of thousands to hundreds of thousands of MIOTY devices, which can send up to 1.5 million messages a day, so to a single gateway. So we see that very high node counts and dense and very dense networks are quite good for MIOTY as well. This includes smart city, smart metering, smart building as well, because you can have a very large building complex with various sensors in the building, for example, and then Industry 4.0 as well.
Okay, yeah, makes sense. So it sounds like kind of large, scalable sensor networks, long lifetime, low power, and also kind of uplink sensor-based communication. Yeah, it makes sense. Sounds very exciting. And what I've really been waiting for, Nicholas, I know that you brought some hardware today. So can you walk us through that? Can we take a look? Can you talk about, you know, what's on there, what radio, and show us that?
So here we have the MIOTY module, which is the world's first completely shielded MIOTY module by Radiocrafts, and this module is pre-certified for European regulations in the 868 megahertz band, and soon to come the 915 megahertz band as well for US. And the module has been designed for really massive IoT deployments because of the feature sets in MIOTY. This module has the MIOTY protocol embedded inside, and we see that this MIOTY module also has a UART interface and AT command sets, where the AT command set is used to set up the module and also to send data from the module to the MIOTY base station as well. And so this module has many interesting features from the MIOTY technology, which is embedded in the module. So we see that it has a very long range of 20 kilometers line of sight and 5 kilometers in an urban environment. So then it can be used, for example, in a large building complex or in a mining or oil field, and it will be no problems. And then we also see many other benefits from the MIOTY protocol itself. For example, the high interference-proof because of the telegram splitting and the redundancy, the ability to lose up to 50% of sub-packets and still be able to have a complete message with all the information still available when the message reaches the gateway. We also see that it has bidirectional communication for firmware upgrades as well. And a very high sensitivity as well, which provides the long range. So there are many benefits to the module, which I've spoken before about when I introduced MIOTY as well. And also it uses a TI chipset, which is similar to all our modules. All our modules have a TI chipset inside, which Nick will elaborate on, I guess.
Yeah, thanks. No, the module looks great. It's very exciting to see that. And I can't wait to get my hands on one myself to play with. And I just think it's really cool. I know that we've had a long partnership with Radiocrafts, and I think it's really cool to see this new technology coming onto the market and how we're working together with the TI radios and your expertise with these modules. So it's very exciting, something that I'm really enjoying watching develop. One last question for you, Nicholas. So how can somebody get started with this technology if they want to start with your module or evaluating?
Okay, so here we have the MIOTY development kit, which was designed for the customer to quickly and easily create a wireless link or wireless network in which they can have a really good analysis of the network performance, in this case, the MIOTY network performance. And inside the development kit, we have two development boards from Radiocrafts, and the development board comes with a MIOTY module on it as well. And then we have two antennas and two USB sticks, or not USB sticks, USB cables, in which you can create a small wireless network for MIOTY and really get to test the capabilities of MIOTY to see if it's right for your application. And we recommend to all our customers that they get a development kit in the evaluation phase of the product, because it is the fastest and easiest way to really see if to really test the network and see if MIOTY is for their application or not. And we also have a second MIOTY module, which I forgot to mention before, which is coming out as well in the end of the year in 2020. And this module the customer is going to be able to create his own customer-specific application, which he can run on the board, which he can run on the module itself. So, and this is based on Radiocrafts Easy framework, which is, in the simplest terms I can put it, it is to tailor the module's behavior to the customer's exact unique requirements, through, for example, configuring the radio network, configuring the hardware interfaces, and configuring when to read and write to those hardware interfaces as well. So that's something to look forward to as well. And that module will also come with its own development kit, which will contain two sensor boards, which have seven industry standard sensors on it, such as two temperature and humidity sensors, accelerometer, Hall detector, LED, and among others. So that allows you also to interface to these different sensors and to really test the second MIOTY module, which we will be releasing as well.
Well, Nicholas, that's very exciting. Thank you very much. I really appreciate you joining us here to talk about MIOTY. Very exciting to see where this new LPWAN protocol goes and how we continue to partner with you, Radiocrafts, to help bring this to market with consumers.
And thank you for having me on the show.
For all the viewers, thank you guys for joining us as well. As always, make sure to tune in. We have more exciting and new topics coming up. And don't forget to check out the podcast as well. Thanks, Nicholas. Thanks, everybody. Bye.